What's up, guys? Welcome back to another YouTube video. Today we have a lot planned. It's gonna be an absolute banger video. We're going to the Zoo Culture opening. Hopefully gonna be able to meet some cool people. Today's pre, we're rocking with the Rise Loaded Pre Kool-Aid. Should taste exactly like Tropical Punch. Most fire pre I've had in a long time. We're here with T Brown.
What's good?
Dude, I can't have any of that. That'll just make me yak, dude. But it does taste really good.
And it hits, bro.
It does hit, yeah.
It hits hard, but it makes you want to.
Makes me nauseous, but it does taste.
You want a scoop or not?
I'll take one anyways, to be honest.
I'll give you a little happy.
Oh yeah.
We're scooping Beely, and we're gonna stop by Best Buy on the way. But other than that, I'll see you guys in there. Go to spot.
Bro, we're fishtailing out every 2 seconds. Cars losing traction.
Worst weather in California for Bradley Martin to be like, hey, yeah, let's open up Zoo Culture.
Yeah, bro, imagine the non-Californian people being
bro,
like,
I've had 10 people DM me like, yeah, I'm flying in from out of state to come to this thing. Like, let's flick up together. I'll be like, hell yeah, bro. I feel so bad for
bro,
that.
It's literally, this is not California
this
weather.
This is not California.
This is wild.
Like, yeah. This is some New York. This is some
That's
Gotham
York,
City
bro.
Ass
yeah.
weather,
yeah,
bro.
Yeah, for real, dude. California weather, my
city streets are crowded with rain.
All right, so we're back at Best Buy, and we're buying more camera equipment.
Why the fuck is Best Buy so confusing?
And
where are
so
the
expensive.
Yeah,
and so expensive.
Right, yeah.
For really no reason.
Get a Juby. What the
hey,
fuck
guys,
is a Juby?
You want a Juby, bro? Hey, bro, that's not okay. That's some suggestive references right there. Come on, man. Got that animal in me. So we're on the way, we're only 10 minutes out, but the only problem is that it is so packed in there that I have no idea how we're gonna get in. One of my boys that is already there and already inside.
You're fucking shit, dude.
One of my boys that's already there and inside said that he might be able to get us in. So I don't know. I'm just gonna show up and be like, I'm here, I guess.
Dude, the line is wrapped around the building.
The line is literally wrapped around the building. So I'm gonna try and get us and everybody in, but we'll see how it goes.
This balls right now.
It's not even that cold outside, bro. He's just being pussy.
Dude, it's raining. This
purple Lambo.
I feel the socks wet as shit, bro. That's like the only pre I need.
Hey, you got wet socks on, dude. You got Jordans on.
Bro, I don't even know, but the socks are wet as hell,
bro. Ugh.
This is sexy, man. Yeah.
Holy shit, talk about people in here.
Hello.
Sure, thanks, bro.
Sure, fuck it, why not?
Yeah.
I got you inside.
Oh, wait, C-bomb.
Can you imagine?
Can you take a picture of you? Oh, no. Appreciate it, C-bomb. Take a picture of you.
Yeah, of course, bro. Of course,
dude.
Of course, dude.
Appreciate it, man.
Of course, yeah.
Shit.
I'm taking one like that. Fuck you.
Appreciate it, yeah.
Hold on, watch y'all hit me.
Oh, you got it. Let's get it. Oh, boy right here, you know what I mean?
Oh yeah.
There you go, my boy. Of course.
Hell yeah.
Yo, I gotta meet Alex, bro. Yo, it's good. I wanna meet Alex.
Woo!
It's nice to meet you officially. We DM'd a couple times.
Right.
Of course, bro. It's good.
Crazy hard, right?
Dude, I'm trying. I mean, I try. Not as hard, bro. It's crazy. It's nice to meet you officially, bro. You're much bigger in person.
Bro, I love that, dude. Guzman told me that, bro. I feel so much better about myself now.
You met my boy Tommy here before.
We met at Fitness 19 when you almost got in that fucking fight.
Oh, yeah.
I remember Max was trying to fight you or some shit.
But what was bro pressing you about?
Bro, he just wanted something to get mad about because he probably knew who I was and wanted to, like, make a scene. I don't know. Like, I don't know if he was trying to make me hit him. And
that's how shit rolls.
Bro, if I can find you later, we should take a flick.
Yeah, definitely.
Absolutely.
So I'll be back here later tonight, probably, most likely, to get, like, an actual workout in.
I was going
to
say, we might come back to get, like, an actual lift in.
But anything's getting done right now. No way.
Hey, bro, it was a pleasure.
You too, bro. God bless you.
It's hot as fuck in here, bro. Oh, there's like 90 heads in here, for real. That's just crazy. This shit is ridiculous, bro. There is so many fucking people here. It's Rowan. Rowan, hold up.
I wanted to meet you in person.
What's up, bro?
Tommy,
you made a video a little bit ago. I want to say there's no beef. Like, meet you in person.
You made a video of me.
Right.
Yeah. Now you're here.
So what do you want me to do?
I just want to say sorry.
I fuck with that.
Of course.
Oh, I fuck. I appreciate that. Yeah.
No love, bro. It's all
everyone
all
thinks
love.
I'm a dickhead and shit, bro. I just respond to my hate comments.
I feel that.
Whatever, bro.
I want to make sure there's no bad blood.
I don't have anything against you, brother.
Of course, bro.
Before, until you stitch my videos, I've seen your videos before and shit.
Much
I don't
love,
have
bro.
Beef with anyone, brother.
Of course.
I don't have
nice
beef
to
with
anyone.
Bro, it made me so sweaty in here, like my pits are dead ass, like dying. Let's try and hit some back. Fuck it.
I guess.
Keep it going!
Holy shit!
Damn!
One more.
Come on. Let's go. Run that shit! Run it! Yes!
Holy shit! Fuck yeah! God damn,
bro!
There we go.
I'm sorry! You guys, we gotta get some people out so we can get more people in! You gotta do that right now!
Well, basically, he's kicking out everybody that isn't famous, so I'm getting a pump in right now. Or at least gonna try. I don't know. I don't think the people over there even heard what Bradley said, so.
He didn't even get to finish, dude. He's like, no more sets for you.
The fuck, bro? I want all the fucking games.
You don't want your sets, bro. I want my sets, bro.
That's the guy I'm impossible.
We couldn't lift for jack shit.
Yeah, facts.
Like, we literally did
we're
not
gotta go.
There's really nothing we could do. There's no way we're really gonna hit a lift. Literally, look over there.
Yeah.
Look over there.
2-3 sets of bench. A little bit of...
Back door. Please don't go to the front door.
Yeah, you see,
and
we're getting kicked out.
And a little bit of the pullovers. We're gonna come back.
Yeah.
We'll hit like arms and chest later tonight, some shit like that. Hey, let's go grab the cam. We'll go to Chipotle, get some food, and we'll be back.
All right. So we're at Chipotle. Absolutely starving. This is the first meal I've had today, and I'm about to down like 900 calories.
Literally the first meal. We haven't eaten shit since we left.
The only problem with that is that we're going back, so I need to make sure that I don't eat a lot of this so that I don't look fat for pictures, because I'm supposed to pose with Alex later. But I can't even describe the energy in there. Absolutely electric. It was...
Dude, thank you to everyone that we met.
Some of the coolest, if not the coolest experience I've had in a really long time.
Shows that you could really do it. Everyone out there could fucking do this shit.
And if anything, it gave me a lot of perspective on the fact that we have a lot of room to grow as influencers, and that, you know, I don't have to lock in on fitness for my life to be like an influencer. You know,
it's all
like,
about personality and
I
outreach.
I can work through my everyday life and people will still fuck with my content. And today, that was a good reminder of that. I met a lot of really cool people, some mutuals that I'd never met before. I got to meet some new people.
Yeah.
I'm just really thankful overall. So thank you to everybody that has followed and supported along my journey so far. And thank you to everybody that I met today. If you have pictures, please DM them to my Instagram, because I would love to see those pictures. I will repost
that
them.
Shit, yeah.
I'll repost them. Just tag me on your Instagram story. And other than that, I'm about to eat, get back to it.
I'm
and
fucking
then
this shit up, man.
We're gonna go lift later, so I'll see you in there.
Damn, look at bro's back. Down!
Come on! Fuck, dude.
Yeah,
that fucked me up right there.
Thing.
Yeah. Yeah. The fucking slap marks. This fool slapped the fucking shit out of me, dude. I was slapping you too, to be honest. Turn around. Yeah, dude, I low-key got him a little bit. Dude, he's not gentle with the slaps.
Fuck being
you
gentle.
You can't be gentle with the slaps.
Fuck being gentle.
I'm not even cap.
Look back at the other clip where you're working out. I'm screaming in your fucking ear.
You can't really be gentle with the shit. This isn't it's a gentleman's sport, but it's not a gentleman's sport.
I know what this kid looks like naked. Why would I not?
Think about that. Bro, what? This fool's wild. I was out of left field.
I'm here with Alex Mendoza.
What's going on, people?
One of my inspirations, one of the guys
on,
that got me into posting on social media.
Come on, bro.
I want to ask,
yes,
if you could give one message to your fans, what would it be?
Stop giving a fuck and do what makes you happy. Fuck people, bro.
There you go.
Yeah. Don't let people limit your potential, man.
There it goes.
That's it.
Alex, thank you.
I appreciate it. No, for real, man. Like,
excellent to meet you.
Like, talking to you guys makes me motivated, because I'll be honest, man, I wanted to, like, give up. And it's overwhelming as fuck, man.
Yeah.
It's a lot to take in, and a lot of people, not enough people, talk about the mental side effects of doing social media, bro.
Right.
It's a fucking lonely road.
Yeah.
It really is. It's not fun and games. It's proper, you know?
Yeah.
So, like, for real, you make my day, man.
It's excellent.
Thank you, bro.
Excellent to meet you, my friend.
Come on.
Let's go. I'll do the first one. I was telling you. It's your world. Come on, let's get that shit. It's you. That boy's the team. Push.
Yeah.
Come on. Yes, good.
Hey, let's go do the shoulder press.
Fucking huge, bigger than me, dude. That's crazy.
That's impressive.
Dude, you gotta hit the most muscular with me.
Let's fucking do it.
Alright, bet.
Let's fucking do it.
You're gonna make my chest look tiny.
Bro.
Of course, my boy.
Are you getting a first one?
You, bro. I haven't gotten one yet. Of course, bro, yeah. If y'all are working out, I might hop in with you guys.
For sure. I'm probably in chest today. I'm a bench. I'm going to try and PR.
Matt, let's see it.
What you going for?
5-3.
Good shit.
Tommy, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, bro. I'm Mike. That's
crazy. What's up? Thank you, bro.
Of course, bro. Nice to meet you.
That's your bit.
How long are you lifting, bro?
8 years.
See? Everybody that looks like us has a crazy amount of numbers under their belt, like years-wise. You gotta be lifting for a long time to have big muscles.
Your aesthetics is fucking off the chain, bro.
I appreciate that. I'm bulking and I'm still lean right now.
What the fuck, bro?
No, I'm bulking. I'm only eating 3,500-ish. So I'm not gaining a lot.
No, it's worth it, bro. Whatever you're doing is fucking worth it.
Shit. Come on, baby! Let's fucking go!
Hit that shit! Dude. Woo. This shit is wild, bro. I'm sweating. I'm not even working out. Damn, dude. It was wet outside. It's wet in here, bro. The air is moist.
It's like humid up in this bitch.
Straight humid in this bitch, bro. Oh my god. Dude, we need to find my backpack. I need to put on deodorant, bro. Oh my god. That shit was too easy.
That's crazy.
You call that a PR? That's too easy.
Holy fuck, you're so much bigger
Appreciate that, bro.
What the fuck?
Is it for real like that, bro?
And you're natural too, yeah?
Yeah. 100% Nadia at 19, bro. Yeah, most of these fools are big as hell. I feel like I can't compete.
He's this morning.
Dude, hold on.
Dude, what the fuck?
Oh, shit.
Dude, holy shit.
You gotta turn it off. Yeah.
What do you do for your front delts? It's like normal shoulder press.
Forward pressing and front raising.
I
do rear delts so much. That's like the main thing I focus on.
I can tell, dude. Yeah.
Every time, dude.
Awesome
your fucking arms
shit.
Like the difference.
I haven't trained arms. I haven't trained my triceps in 2 months, and I haven't trained my biceps in a month.
You haven't trained your triceps in 2 months?
I think it overpowers my shoulder. My dad's got cracked arm genetics. I don't want the arm genetics. I want the chest and delts, dude.
That's how I feel. Because I have big arms.
Dude, if I trained arms like 3 days a week, they would just overpower
everything.
I would
give you some chest. I don't like my chest.
Let's fucking swap that.
Give me some, bro.
I don't even give a fuck.
I'm tired.
This shit is ridiculous, bro. So many people here, dude. Like, everyone's here.
No,
it's ridiculous.
Dude.
Come on, bro. This is about to be the third time. It's about the third time they're going to come up and be like, you need to leave. We have it on camera of Brad saying that we're good to go. Like, I'm just gonna show him the clip and then he'll be like, no. We are good to stay. Sorry about that, sorry.
Squeeze! Come on!
Let's go!
Come on!
Chest up!
Receiver! Daddy Sebo!
Keep your chest up at the top! Keep your chest up at the top!
Come on!
Let's go!
For Daddy Sebo!
Dude, Hoy! Bro, this has been the craziest lift I've had. Bro's in the Wakanda. Bro's got the Wakanda like dress. Bro, what's going on, bro?
Exit towards the back door now.
I'm so annoyed with their voice right now. Like, no hard feelings, but like, holy shit, it's the same thing playing over and over again. Dude, holy shit.
Like, I know they have to do their job, but if they play this clip like 400 more times, I'm gonna rip my hair out.
You are by far the hardest working like athlete I have ever
seen.
No,
he's not. I know.
No, I'm fucking with you.
What's your name, bro?
I'm Aiden.
Aiden?
It's
nice Tommy,
to
it's
you.
Excellent to meet you, bro.
Yeah,
I appreciate
really,
that, bro.
Really no, awesome. For real. Yeah, I like it.
Meeting people like you is why I do it, bro.
Thank you.
Of course.
Yeah.
Nice to meet you, Aiden.
Nice to meet you.
I got the same tank, bro. This thing makes you look huge.
I know, it's the best thing ever.
Oh yeah,
bro, what are you? Look at the ice.
Thank you, I appreciate it. It's all fake. I have to be honest. It's all fake.
And
but
the rings.
Hell yeah, bro.
Yeah,
what's your name?
Aaron
Tommy.
Nice to meet you,
my friend.
Appreciate you.
Lex, if you had one piece of advice to give to your followers and fans, what would it be?
You mean like social media fitness, or do you mean like genuine individual?
Genuine individual.
Individual advice that I give to somebody, how long can this be?
As long as you want.
Individual advice that I would give, let me get a little closer. Individual advice that I give to someone is unlock your self-awareness, because a lot of the times, like, you don't even really know how that you're coming across to other people. And, you know, when you could come across so absurdly rude or egotistical or a lot of these things to a person, and it's almost like turns into like a subjective sword of a bunch of individuals. So you are the one person in the emotional relationship thinking, you know what, logically and objectively speaking, I know how I'm betraying myself because I am myself and no one can tell me otherwise. That creates problems, because if you have 100 people in a room, if you have 100 people in a room tell you that you're being a certain way, like maybe like 100 people tell you in a room, they're like, yo man, you're just kind of being an asshole. And you're like, why am I being an asshole? Like, what am I doing wrong? Give me an example. I don't believe you. Instead of defending yourself, you need to realize that all relationships are subjective. They're not objective. Emotions are involved, and emotions don't hold any logic. So if everyone around you is telling you that you're a certain way, they're not doing that because they're jealous of you. They're doing it because they're warning you that you're betraying yourself in a certain way that you might not realize. So, and the first thing you should do when a lot of your friends come to you and really tell you, listen, man, I feel like, let's say this, right? Let's say you blow up and people are like, yo, man, you're kind of switching up. Instead of thinking, why am I not switching up? Why are they wrong? Think, why do my friends feel this way? What am I doing wrong? Even if I don't think that I'm doing anything wrong, let me look deep within myself. Let me think about the past. What have I done to them that makes them feel this way? And I'm going to ask them what it is, and if they tell me, I'm going to try to work on it, because that's what relationships are.
No, respect, bro. I appreciate
bro,
that.
Bro, that got deep as hell.
Start right here. On you or from here? Honest. Or honest.
I have absolutely no words to describe today other than...
fucking insane.
Amazing. Yeah. I mean, today was probably the most interesting, best, most humbling ever fitness experience I've ever had.
It's like humbling but eye-opening at the same time.
Yeah, if anything, it gave me a realistic idea of just how much I have to grow and how much
proves that we could do it,
and how much success there really is to earn. I'm beyond grateful for all of the love that you guys have showed me. Today was a great day to network with creators that I met, you know, people that I've been following and for a long time and look up to, and most importantly, being able to meet a lot of you guys. I mean, I was signing belts left and right. I was...
hella people came up to this.
I got to take pictures with like 100 of you guys. Like,
love
I am
that.
I am beyond grateful. And the only words that I have to give you guys is thank you. So with that, thank you guys so much for watching my beautiful, sexy, lovely, amazing people. And I'll see you in the next video.